From Ocean Springs, Mississippi, Yeah.
It's just a kind thing.
Thank you.
Thank you. Young boy, I got merch boxes to get.
All right, we're here with El Psycho Gato.
You again.
And tonight, you and the superstar bodyguard known as Shorty will take on MT2 and Eddie G. Now, this time it's a tag match between both MT2 and Eddie G. Now, with Eddie G being able to get involved technically, officially, without getting himself and his partner, whatever he wants to call him, disqualified. How do you feel about tonight's match between you, the superstar bodyguard, and MT2 and Eddie G?
How do I feel? I feel, you know what? What do I smell? I smell fish. I smell trash. I smell something dirty in the air. Eddie G can finally get in the ring with us. He can finally lock up with me, if he knows how. He can finally throw blows with me. We all know MT2 blows. Now, what is he gonna do to us? The same thing he always does, waits for the referee to turn his back, get a cheap shot in, yada, yada, yada. It's always the same thing with Eddie G. Let's get back on track. MT2 sucks.
As you can see, I'm in 7 pounds.
due to the DCW authorities, that would be Gene Miller. And if I didn't wear it, we would not get our title shot. So Gene Miller, I've got news for you. I got in touch with my attorneys, and they said they're going to touch with you.
Get a hold of us.
That's right. And what was the news there, Mr. Miller?
Stipulation is this is a title match. But the stipulation this match is whoever gets the pinfall will be the champ.
That is correct.
So that means if not, he can win or Agato can win. If you happen to get dumb luck and fall down on top of somebody on the top three, you'd be the champion and you'd have to try to defend it anyway.
That's right. So tonight, from my understanding, the Golf Players Championship title is on the line in this tag match. Is that correct, Mr. Miller?
That is correct. You give them all a ring announcer to the microphone so we can
show you. There you go. Let's get this one down the road.
Thank you.
least he left it on. Gato, we saw you and the superstar bodyguard lose the championship, the Gulf Coast Championship tonight. How does that make you feel?
Shut up, Walter. 3 weeks, MT2 is done.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall out of this four. The DCW Tag Team Championships. Introducing first the champions from Broken Arrow, Oklahoma, weighing in at 469 pounds combined. T-Wolf and Half-Breed, they are native blood.
boots to him.
Oh!
nice guy.
The screw job in Pascagoula. The Pascagoula screw job took place. There's no way JC gets out except referee counts one, two just fine. But three takes a long time for the referee. Vladimir Koloff is pissed because J.C. Stokes is new DCW television champion. J.C. Stokes, just like all of you lying, cheating, pathetic Americans, cheat his way into taking my title.
I want my title back.
So if he wants a rematch with Pascagoula for this, he's got to put something on the line as well. My TV title versus your mask.
Thank you. watermelon.
Thank you.
time for Walter's Gulf Coast Wrestling Review, and I'm here, first time ever, with the man known as Barry Wolf. Tonight, you've got a match once again with Sean Black to take that heavyweight championship from him. How do you feel about what's coming up tonight?
Sean Black, when I first got the call to come to Diamond Championship Wrestling, they told me, look, we need somebody to challenge our champion. So I showed up. Now, granted, I didn't want to scare you off until that first moment that bell rang and I stepped into the ring, I already seen the fear in your eyes. Now, what I did not know was the lackey that you would have. You know, that looks like a Q-tip that's been rolled around on a barber floor. What's his name? O'Malley. That's right, O'Malley. He comes out, interferes in our match. The Loco Lobo knows better now. Tonight, here in Pascagoula, the Gula, I'm taking what's mine, and I will become the new DCW champion. That's all I gotta say.
Here, outside the Pascagoula VFW, with the heavyweight champion perfection, Sean Black. Tonight, Sean, you gotta once again face the man known as Barry Wolf. Now, a lot of people been talking how the last time you faced him, you had to use Steve O'Malley to win that match. So, what do you gotta say tonight about tonight's main event?
Yeah, Walter, I don't recall using Steve O'Malley to win anything. I recall me getting the pin 1-2-3 off of Barry Wolf's mistake. I don't recall using anyone. But that being said, Barry Wolf, if you're listening, if you're watching, you, sir, have earned my respect. I give credit where credit's due, and you gave me a run for my money. So, but at the same time, since we're talking about Steve O'Malley, I've seen the interview you two had. Why don't you go ahead and break down some of the things he said, Walter.
Well, I asked him why did he side with you, and he come back and said that the supposed John Cena of the Gulf Coast came to him and asked for forgiveness. And that leaves me to wonder, who really does lead the resistance here, Sean? Is it you, or is Steve using you as a pawn in his game?
Well, here's how it is, Walter. How to put this nicely. I feel bad for O'Malley. I took everything he had. I took his belt. I took his sister. I took it all. And I felt bad. If it wasn't for me, he would be at the bottom right now instead of where he is at the top. If it wasn't for me, he would be a nothing. He wouldn't even work for this company. So as of the resistance of Steve O'Malley is no more. Now you have Sean Black, the heavyweight champion, and I'm going to do it all alone. You can get it.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 60-minute time limit. Your official for this contest, Roger Beanbag Bernoulli.
Oh! Thank you.
Dean Austin. I'm sorry.
Yeah.